Christina. In this video, I want to share with you what I noticed about the similarities between Russians and Egyptians. I mentioned before in my videos that I feel pretty at home in Egypt, and today I want to share with you why I feel so. The topic of today's video is neighbors. You know, in Russia when I was a child, it was absolutely normal to go to my neighbor to ask for a little bit of salt if it's finished, to ask for one bulb of onion, or to ask for one egg, because while you cook the cake, you need four eggs, and of course you have only three. So I will not go shopping for one egg. I will simply go and ask my neighbor for one egg. Later, I will buy and give it this egg back. That was absolutely normal with my neighbors in Russia. I didn't expect, but when I came to Egypt, I found that it's absolutely normal to have the same here. At least with the people I deal with. I talk about the middle class people. I don't know about the poor people. I don't know about the very rich people. I can only tell you about the life of the middle class. Yeah, the people I know. So, for example, what I like about Ramadan time. It's absolutely fine, and it's a very nice tradition when in Ramadan people keep exchanging plates of food. My neighbors always come to me at the beginning of Ramadan sharing a plate of dates or a plate of different Egyptian sweets. In return, I do the same. I cook Egyptian sweets. I do my best to cook Egyptian sweets so that Egyptians can eat them. I hope it's eatable for them. So I also send a plate of sweets to my neighbors back. And I believe it's a very nice tradition. It makes people feel so friendly and so close to each other. Another example, you know, in Egypt, we have natural gas. In the old areas, we have the pipes. So the gas comes to the flats and you can cook, no problem. In the old areas. In the new areas, in some new compounds or new streets where the buildings are still new, maybe them like 5 years or less, we don't have these pipes. So we use something called mbuba. It's a gas cylinder. So you buy it, use it, and then you have to exchange. Honestly, I thought this kind of mbuba disappeared many years ago, but we still use them in Egypt. So guess what happens? When you cook for your guests or in the middle of the preparation for the lunch, in the very important moment, it becomes empty. You run out of gas. What should I do? Till I call someone to bring for me another cylinder, till they exchange it, it takes time. Because I cannot do it myself. It's heavy and I will not carry and I cannot change it myself. So, honestly, I did it a couple of times. I took my meal, which was half ready, and I went to my neighbors. I asked them to just cook it in their ovens. And you know, no one refused. They always said, yes, of course, and they cooked it for me, and they kept offering any other help if I need. And with these neighbors, we're not friends. We're just neighbors. But they're very friendly, and they're very sharing, and they always offer help. I asked different neighbors to do that for me, and they always helped me. So thank you, my dear friends. I really appreciate that. So from this, I can say that Egyptian neighbors, the same like Russian neighbors, are very friendly and very sharing. So if you plan to come and live in Egypt, you will find people here very open, so, and very welcoming, you know? So you will feel at home here. That's it for today. Thank you for watching. See you soon. Bye!